Herbert Maschner. I'm President and Chief Scientist of Global Digital Heritage, an international nonprofit dedicated to documenting heritage around the world in 3D, 2D, and various virtualization techniques. Well, we use reality capture primarily for two reasons. The first is our ability to rapidly integrate terrestrial photogrammetry, aerial photogrammetry, and laser scans in an efficient and complete way. The second reason we use it is because it's so fast. So when we're doing very large museum collections where we're dealing with hundreds of artifacts at a time, reality capture is the only technique, the only software that allows us to efficiently process large volumes of data. And when we're talking about large volumes, we're talking about hundreds of thousands of photos.
In a number of different ways, reality capture has really helped our workflow. And we're really finding it, particularly for museum work, museum collections, that it's sort of a beginning to end kind of software. We're able to really just stay in reality capture from image alignment through reconstruction, mesh cleaning and texturing, and to publishing to Sketchfab.
It's a really a one-stop program for 3D and photogrammetry. And just the expediency at which it operates and the quality at which it operates, it's really helped us in the museum setting, but also in the more landscape setting of cultural heritage sites. That's a real added benefit for us because we do a lot of laser scanning in addition to photogrammetry. So having a software that is easy to use and can combine all these types of data sets is a real benefit for us and for anybody who wants to use reality capture.
Fundamentalmente que desarrollo dentro de Global Digital Heritage se basa en la fotogrametría. En el campo de los museos es la tecnología o la técnica principal con la que estamos trabajando. Desde que hemos incorporado el software de RealityCapture, podemos además trabajar mucho más rápido, lo que nos permite procesar grandes volúmenes de datos y poner a disposición de los ciudadanos un mayor número de artefactos y piezas arqueológicas.
Me ocupo principalmente del trabajo con dron, de fotogrametría aérea. Primero hacemos una toma sistemática de imágenes para obtener la ortoimagen y hacemos barridos fotográficos en doble retícula para obtener el máximo detalle posible.
So this was an in-field alignment from yesterday of Miguel Angel's drone images, the close-up shots that he did of the capitals and the columns.
And being able to do this, this initial alignment in RC is wonderful, and then you know, continuing the processing once we get back to the office, and it just works really well with all the different types of data sets that we use.
Reality capture has really transformed our ability to put entire museum collections online. Before, we were unable to process enough imagery in an efficient amount of time to be able to really deal with museum collections as a whole. And now we can deal with hundreds of artifacts and create virtual repositories anywhere in the world. Reality capture makes it possible for us to do these kinds of projects because not only are we integrating all the different kinds of data necessary to scan a monumental structure like the Montemore Novo Castle. Reality Capture really helps us because of the speed and ease at which we can produce 3D models and make them available to the public. Everyone can benefit from Reality Capture, from beginners to advanced professionals. The workflow is straightforward and fairly easy, and there's a great user base to provide help when needed.